This video will show you how to use ColorFront Transcoder for Dolby Vision quality control. We will explore two workflows: quality control of a ProRes file with a Dolby Vision Sidecar XML, and quality control of a Dolby Vision IMF package. Let's start with the ProRes workflow. First, import the ProRes and add it to the timeline using the V shortcut. Then import the Dolby Vision XML file and apply it to the ProRes on the timeline. To do this, navigate to File, Dolby Vision, and select Apply XML Master Metadata to Events on Active Track. There are some useful validation tools available in Transcoder that can be used to check the integrity of the Dolby Vision metadata. Under File, Dolby Vision, select Dolby Vision XML Validation. This window can also be opened using the Ctrl-D shortcut. Make sure that the markers option is turned on, then select Dolby Vision for the test plan. Next, press Start. When prompted by a pop-up window whether to generate PQ statistics, select Yes. Transcoder then calculates PQ statistics for the entire timeline, which are used to compare against the Dolby Vision metadata. Transcoder checks that the Dolby Vision metadata edits match the scene edits. Once the calculation of the PQ statistics is complete, various validation processes related to Dolby Vision are started, including the Dolby Metafire validation. To open the validation report, press the Open button directly in the validation window. You can get more details on any processes that require further investigation once the report is open. Step 5, Validate Edits validation mentions two markers that have been added to the timeline. We will investigate these to see if there are any issues with the metadata. Before we examine these markers, let's jump to the node pipeline by pressing Enter. Add a CMU node to the node pipeline to visually inspect the metadata by mapping to a selected target display. On the node page, right-click, select Color Space, CMU, and attach it to the node pipeline. Leave the target display set to 100 nit rec 709. To update the GUI viewer to SDR viewing, use the Ctrl F11 shortcut. The markers in the timeline may indicate possible changes in the Dolby Vision metadata that do not match a scene cut. When returning to the timeline to examine the second marker, you will notice a shift in the Dolby Vision metadata in the middle of a shot. The image luminance also shifts as you toggle back and forth. To quickly verify whether the metadata values change, open the Media Metadata window using Shift U and select D for the Dolby metadata. Now we can observe how the metadata values shift in the middle of this shot. Another useful tool for looking at luminance changes compared to shot cuts is the graph window. Select Window, Analysis, Show Graph Window. This view provides a visual representation of the per-frame light level statistics using various metrics such as HDR 10-frame averages and peaks, as well as minimum, average, and maximum PQ values using the Dolby Vision L1 calculation. You can view the graph both in light values, which represent the HDR 10 statistics, and in PQ values, which represent the Dolby L1 statistics. Once all validation steps are completed, start the visual QC. To map to different target displays, simply open the CMU node and select the appropriate target display color space and its corresponding display and configuration. Now let's look at the Dolby Vision IMF QC workflow. While many of the steps remain the same, there are a few additional validation types that we will cover. First, import the CPL into the project using the drop-down menu under Timeline, Import IMP CPL. Then run the Dolby Vision validation using the Ctrl-D shortcut. Select Yes to create PQ stats. Once the PQ statistics calculations are complete, the Dolby Vision validation tests begin. Two tests specific to Dolby Vision IMF QC are the L6 sanity test and the Validate IMF CPL metadata test. The L6 sanity check examines the maxvol and maxcll values of the content. It checks whether maxvol is larger than maxcll, whether any L1 value indicates a significantly brighter peak luminance than the maxcll, and finally, whether there are any MaxFall and MaxCLL mismatches between CPL and Dolby Vision XML. The Validate IMF CPL metadata test compares the Dolby Vision Master XML to the IMF CPL asset values and checks various parameters such as frame rate, color encoding primaries, aspect and active image area, master display primaries, and luminance range. To map the content with the applied Dolby Vision metadata to different target displays, apply a CMU node to the node pipeline and select the appropriate target display color space. Finally, choose its corresponding display and configuration.